Hi everyone, this is Dr. Fox. Let's talk about the kidney. The kidneys, as you know, are found within the retroperitoneal space. And the retroperitoneal space may be further subdivided into smaller spaces. In particular, with respect to this session, we'll show you the anterior and posterior pararenal spaces, as well as the perirenal space. So the pararenal spaces are the regions of the retroperitoneum which are found superficial to the renal fascia. So in this photograph, we can see that this individual has grabbed a hold of the renal fascia and is pulling it laterally, demonstrating some of its elasticity. So anything outside of this space is going to be the anterior pararenal space. And some of the organs of the digestive system, which are retroperitoneal, such as the duodenum and the pancreas, can be found in this anterior pararenal space, as well as copious amounts of adipose connective tissue, which have largely been removed for the purposes of this photograph. The posterior pararenal space is found posterior to the perirenal space and renal fascia, and is a space devoid of viscera and only contains adipose connective tissue. Here we can see a similar view as in the last photograph, with the renal fascia or perirenal fascia incised and removed. So this region here would be a part of the anterior pararenal space and would be filled with adipose connective tissue in vivo. And this area here that I'm shading is within the perirenal space. I always think of it peri, I is inside the renal fascia. And this is the adipose connective tissue, which is enveloping the kidney. And this space is contiguous with the renal sinus, which is found deep through the hilum of the kidney. We can see some of the other contents of the perirenal space while we're here, such as the suprarenal or adrenal gland, as well as the ureter there. So here is the star of our show. This is the kidney that I'm outlining. We can see the convex lateral border, and we can see the medial border here with its hilum and the hilar contents. I can see a very beautiful right renal vein, as well as a right renal artery and an accessory right renal artery, which is hilar, because it's going into the serve the kidney at the hilum. I can also see this beautiful renal fibrous capsule, that connective tissue which is surrounding the parenchyma of the kidney. So the kidney parenchyma, as you recall, consists of an outer cortex and an inner medulla. The outer cortex is going to consist of the cortical arches and the renal columns. The columns are the spaces that interleave between the medulla. The medulla is organized into pyramids here. We call them pyramids, but they're really conical in nature. And the apices of the pyramids are the renal papillae. And here we can see a renal papilla surrounded by a minor calyx. So as you may recall, at that apex of the pyramid, at that renal papilla, we have the end of all of the physiological functions of the nephron and its tubules and collecting ducts, and the filtrate is unambiguously urine for the conduction away from the kidney. This space here, in which we have branches of the renal artery, so segmental arteries and interlobar arteries, as well as veins, which are not pictured here, as well as elements of the excretory pathway, so minor calyces and some major calyces, is the renal sinus. So that renal sinus is going to be everything beyond, so the space beyond the hilum of the kidney, surrounded by parenchyma, through which neurovasculature, as well as perirenal adipose connective tissue, is going to be found. So specifically with the excretory pathway, that begins with the minor calyces. You can see two very nice minor calyces surrounding renal papilla here. And these are going to coalesce into major calyces. Generally, there are three or four minor calyces per major calyx, and two to three major calyces per kidney. There we have another major calyx coming down. And where these major calyces coalesce is the renal pelvis. So here is that renal pelvis, and that is going to be contiguous with the ureter. The ureters will conduct that urine down through the retroperitoneum into the pelvic cavity and through the wall of the urinary bladder. So we've discussed where the kidneys are located, the different components of the retroperitoneum, which are germane to this session, as well as the elements of the kidney itself. Thank you very much for your time.